Welcome viewers, welcome to Subhas Biology. Today's topic is post-fertilization events. What are the events that occur after double fertilization? Today we will discuss one by one. Let's start. Before starting, I want to tell you, please subscribe my channel for more video. Post-fertilization events that include the development of endosperm, development of embryo, and the development of a seed and development of fruit. And all the event, all the terms that collectively called as post-fertilization events. Post-fertilization event that include endosperm formation, embryo formation, seed formation, and fruit formation. One by one we'll discuss. First thing is endosperm. How endosperm development occurs after post-fertilization? Listen carefully. The endosperm which is formed first before embryo development, because endosperm that provide nourishment, that give nutrient to the embryo development. That's why endosperm first develop before embryo development. And this endosperm which is produced from the, which is differentiated from the primary endosperm, and this primary endosperm which is formed after double fertilization of the embryo sac and after fusion of one male gamete with the secondary nuclei. What is secondary nuclei? Now central cell which contains two polar nuclei, and before triple fusion this polar two nuclei that combine and that form the secondary nucleus, and this secondary nucleus that fusion with the male gamete and that form the triploid primary endosperm. And this triploid primary endosperm later on divides repeatedly and to form a triploid endosperm. And this triploid endosperm which is rich in food material and that provide nutrition to the developing embryo. Pair which undergoes successive nuclear division, that means only karyokinesis. Primary endosperm nucleus which undergoes successive nuclear division or only karyokinesis, which is not followed by the cytokinesis. Sirf nucleus ka division hoga and that form free nuclei, and this is called as free nuclear endosperm. When the pair which undergoes karyokinesis or nuclear division and that give rise to free nuclei, and this is called as free nuclear endosperm. And subsequently the cell wall formation occurs, and when cell wall forms then that is that becomes cellular endosperm. In case of a coconut water, the free nuclear endosperm water is called as free nuclear endosperm, and the white kernel is called as cellular endosperm. And endosperm may be consumed completely during embryo development, otherwise it may be consumed during germination of a seed. But this endosperm, the main function of the endosperm that provide nourishment or nutrient to the seed or embryo. Next is embryo development. How embryo development occurs? The zygote that give rise to the embryo, and this zygote which is present toward the micropylar end of the embryo cell, and this zygote starts its development only after some amount of endosperm form, because for the development of the zygote that needs some nutrient, and this nutrient which is provided by the endosperm. That's why endosperm first form, then zygote development occurs. And this zygote which develop into embryo through different stage, and these are pro-embryo, globular stage, heart shape, and mature embryo. Finally they form mature embryo and which is ready for the germination. Then how the zygote which give rise to the a mature embryo. First of all, this is the embryo sac, and this embryo sac that contains antipodal cell and egg apparatus, and this is primary endosperm nucleus or central cell or lateral that gives rise to primary endosperm nucleus. After fertilization, this is the structure of embryo sac, and in this embryo sac, the central cell that convert into primary endosperm nucleus and egg cell that convert into zygote, and these are the degenerating antipodal cell. And whatever the end that contains antipodal cell, this end is called as chalazal end, and its opposite end is called as micropylar end. That means the end which contains zygote, the end which contains zygote, that end is called as micropylar end, and the end which contains antipodal cell is called as chalazal end. And this zygote, which undergoes successive division, asymmetrical division and mitotic division, and due to this asymmetrical mitotic division that form two unequal cells, one is small, another one is large. And the small cell which is present toward the chalazal end, and the large cell which is present toward the micropylar end. And this small cell which is called as terminal cell or apical cell or embryonal cell, and this small cell with that contains more cytoplasm, and this small cell which is present toward the chalazal end, and the large cell which is called basal cell, or though it is larger than the lower one, and this larger daughter cell which is present toward the micropylar end, and this large cell which undergoes the transverse mitotic division, and that give rise to suspensor cells. And this suspensor cell later on that give rise to the globular embryo, then heart shaped embryo, then a mature embryo. And up to this, all the stages are similar in monocot as well as in dicot embryo. First thing, the zygote which develop or which divide into two cells, small and larger cells, larger cell which give rise to the suspensor cells, and later on that give rise to globular embryo, then heart shaped embryo, then mature embryo. Now we discuss the structure of a dicot embryo. The dicot embryo which consists of two cotyledons, that's why that is called as a dicot. These are two cotyledons, and both the cotyledons which is present at both sides of the embryonal axis. Each and every dicot embryo that consists of embryonal axis and two cotyledon. Embryonal axis which contains plumule and radical. The plumule, it is the outgrowing part, or the above part is called as plumule, and the lower one is called as radical. And this plumule which give rise to the shoot system, and the radical which give rise to the root system. And the cotyledon which is present above the cotyledon, the embryonal axis which is present above the cotyledon is called as epicotyl. This one is epicotyl, and the terminal part is called as plumule. And the embryonal axis which is present below the cotyledon, then that is called as hypocotyl. And the terminal part of the hypocotyl is called as radical. And this radical which is supported by root cap. This is all about structure of a dicot embryo. And now we discuss about the structure of monocot embryo. The monocot embryo which contains only one cotyledon, and this cotyledon in case of a grass family is called as cuticulum, and it is very very important. Maximum time the question will come, jyada se jyada ye question aa raha hai, ek mark mein aayega, what is cuticulum or what is the cotyledon in grass family called as dash, that is scutellum. In case of grass family, the cotyledon is called as scutellum, and this scutellum, which is situated or present towards one side of the embryonal axis, look at this. This is scutellum or cotyledon, and this scutellum, which is present at one side of the embryonal axis, this is embryonal axis, and at one side of the embryonal axis that contains cotyledon, and this cotyledon in case of grass family is called as scutellum. And the embryonal axis, which contains shoot apex or plumule and root apex, or that is called as radical. And this plumule, which is covered by a sheath, and that sheath is called as coleoptile. It is very very important. The sheath which covers the plumule is called as coleoptile, and the sheath which covers the radical is called as coleorhiza. Radical supported or covered by sheath, that is called as coleorhiza, and plumule which covered by sheath, that is called as coleoptile. And in case of a monocot also, the embryonal axis which is present above the cotyledon is called as epicotyle, and the embryonal axis which is present below the cotyledon is called as hypocotyle. Next is the monocot embryo that contains a seed, and this seed, it is the final product of the sexual reproduction, and seed consists of seed coat, cotyledon and embryonal axis. And in case of monocot, that contains one cotyledon. In case of dicot, that contains two cotyledon. And the mature seed without endosperm is called as non-albuminous seed, and a part of endosperm retained in the mature seed, that is called as albuminous. If the seed contains endosperm, then that is called as albuminous seed. Without endosperm, that is called as non-albuminous seed. And the remainder of the nucellus, which is present in mature seed, is called as perisperm, and it is very very important. What is perisperm? The remainder of the nucellus in mature seed is called as perisperm, and example is black pepper, beet, that contains perisperm. And the wall of the fruit that develop into the wall of the ovary, which develop into wall of fruit, and that is called as pericarp. Exam mein tumhara jyada question aa raha hai, the differentiate between perisperm and pericarp. Perisperm, it is the remnant of nucellus, and pericarp, it is the outer wall of the fruit. And fruit which develop from the ovary, and seed which develops from the ovule. And fruits are of two types, false fruit and true fruit, and also the fruit and another types of fruit also there, that is parthenocarpic fruit. And later on we will discuss what is true fruit, what is false fruit detail. And what is true fruit? Now I told you what is true fruit. If the fruit develops from the ovary, then that is called as true fruit. If the fruit that develops from the ovary along with some accessory carpellary part, then that is called as false fruit. And false fruit that include apple, strawberry, cashew, and this is also very very important. I will discuss in the next video. And if the fruit that develop without fertilization, then that is called as parthenocarpic fruit.